so in terms of the national picture, Office for National Statistics show that 500,000, half a million men are victims of partner abuse every year, 1.1 million women. Now, there's lots of research that suggests that that figure is actually the same, in terms of it's actually equal. But what we're trying to do with the charity is make sure the issue is on the agenda, and then we can move on to disputing and discussing the statistics. If we do the statistics first, we never end up talking about the issues. I mean, what's significant about the research is that really the men are saying that they suffer partner abuse in terms of physical injuries more than women. And in terms of fathers, I looked at the statistics this week. We know, the ManKind Initiative, and everyone here knows, and all those involved in this sector, especially in terms of supporting fathers, that children are actually used as a reason to keep control of a man or a father in a domestic abuse relationship. So why do men start? We have concern about our children. 9 out of 10 men who don't leave a relationship when there's domestic abuse, it's because they've got children, they believe marriage for life, they still love their partner, they think she'll change, and she won't. But she won't change. And also, more importantly, these last two in some respects is about that there's nowhere to go, they don't know how to leave, where to go, and also they feel embarrassed. Why don't they tell anyone? Who do they not tell? 3 times as many men don't tell anyone that a woman does when they're a victim of partner abuse. Same type of trend when it comes to health professionals, counsellors and therapists. And also, 4 out of 5 people who call our helpline have actually never told anyone at all that they're a victim of domestic abuse. Some of the barriers, and I took a lot of conferences about some of the differences between man and female victims. First one, and I'm happy to make sure these slides are available after the conference, is around male identity. You know, men don't recognise they're a victim. There's issues around shame and embarrassment. Men are strong, resilient, and provide security in a household. And I was at a conference when I actually mentioned that third bullet point, and people looked at me, you know, sceptically. I was asked questions afterwards with regard to, well, do men need to change? Well, I don't think. I think society and also the support services available to domestic abuse victims, they are the ones that need to change. Those characteristics of men are what is what society to where it is today. So why should men change? There's the believability of the victims. Men feel that they won't be believed by family and friends and the police, and also we know that there's still pockets of resistance to actually believe men are victims of domestic abuse. It's all very well said in that situation, but what can we do? There's a couple of things, and I'm sure most of you know about those. First of all, there's a Housing Act, 1996. Every local authority has a legal duty to provide emergency housing for victims of domestic abuse. Now, far too many don't apply that to male victims. And if a man turns up to the council with children or without children, the council have a legal duty to provide housing support for them. And I think that's an important issue that often tends to be overlooked. But councils have a legal duty. If they can't provide the same support as they would a mother with children, then they're in breach of that. Last, a couple of others, the public sector equality duty. It came into force in 2010 as part of the Equality Act. And that can be used to challenge councils, police forces and others to make sure that their services are also now victim friendly. If a man can't get support from a local council or from the health service, but a woman could, they're in breach of the Equality Act. We're really starting to look for cases where we can take some legal action against some councils and police forces who have actually been in breach of those two issues, and we're looking to try and get some case studies and some examples where we can going to take that on. Obviously, there's support for fathers and domestic abuse charities. And it's a point I often say, you know, obviously, the comment was made about keyboard warriors. And there's one thing for everyone to talk about these issues, but it's another to actually try and set up some services or support existing organisations.